Hey there, and welcome to my YouTube channel. My name's Anna Carolina Pereira. I am a college professor at the Ringling College of Art and Design, technical artist and VR developer by day, character artist by night, and Zbrush Live official streamer. I also offer online classes and one-on-one mentorships, so if you're interested in working with me, feel free to check the links below. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create cloth seams and stitch brushes in Zbrush with a really easy-to-follow step-by-step. I don't know about you, but every time I try to find this information online, I only find clickbait videos which aren't even real tutorials, brush demos designed to get you to buy their brushes, and things that are way too complicated and require way too many programs. In this video, I'll be using mostly ZBrush with one quick step in Photoshop. If you don't have Photoshop, you can use whatever image editing software you have. Let's get started!
The first step of creating your seam brush is to create an alpha for it. This process will be done exactly the same as my alpha video, so if you haven't seen that yet, make sure to. We start by clicking the comma button to open up the lightbox, and then we're going to go to the project tab, miscellaneous, right here, and we're going to select one of the brush 3D templates. I'm going to choose the last one, which is the highest definition one, and there we have it. On the spline, I'm going to sculpt the cloth fold that I want to do. This is where you can have some fun. Do whatever type of seam that you wish to do. Do your research. There's a lot of photos on the internet. I'm going to do a simple seam for the back of my button-up shirt. I'm going to mask out one of the side that doesn't have the seam. Then I want to use symmetry, but not the automatic X symmetry. I'm going to go to transform, and instead of X, I'm going to turn that off, and I'm going to click Y. That way, symmetry can go up and down like this, which will help me create a straight line for the seam. You want your seam to match up at the top and bottom. So if you accidentally make like a seam that's at a diagonal, that's not going to work. I'm going to mask out the very edges of my plane as well, because the less deformed the edges of the plane are, the better. I'm going to inflate the very edge here, because that's where my seam will live. Then I'm going to take the move brush, make it really big, and then just kind of slide all this over to the side, trying to keep it as straight as possible up and down. And then I'm going to turn down my smoothing intensity and just kind of gently smooth that out. Let's check it. Smooth top and bottom here. This is going to be the main body of the seam though, so it's okay to have untileable at the top and bottom. To create my folds, I'm going to use the curve pinch brush, and I'm going to use this alpha, alpha 61. To learn more about my tricks to use this brush to make cloth, please watch my easy cloth folds video. I'm going to try to straighten out the edges. Again, the edges are relatively irrelevant. I'm going to go up a few subdivisions and continue detailing it just a little bit until I'm happy. If you need more contrast, go to Deformation, find the contrast slider, and then increase it a little bit. Let's make it more dramatic by a little bit. If you want to add some quick, easy stitches, you can just append a sphere, select it, make it way smaller, stitch size, then squish it on two axes, like this. Move it so that it's mostly through your plane, and then put it in the position that you wish for it to take place. Like that. Move it all the way to the top. Leave a little room because we're going to fix that anyway, just leave the stitches out of it. Then control, drag, copy the stitch over. Once you're happy with the distance, let go of control but not of the gizmo. And then continue moving slowly your stitches. These are very simple. You probably want to sculpt out some better stitches, but they're really nice. I'm just going to move this one out of the picture. Make sure that they're all visible. Got this little guy right here. And then look at it from far away because it's not going to be seen super close up. See if you like it. Do any smoothing you need to do. And then once you're ready to capture the alpha, we're going to do it the exact same way that we did it in my video for how to make alphas. And plus, in that video, I detail a lot of ways to use them. So if you haven't seen that, make sure to do that as well. I'm going to take off the constrained proportions button, make my documents 1024 by 1024, which is going to be a perfect power of 2 square. Going to hit resize. Yes. Control N to clear the document and just draw your model back in. Go to edit. Go ahead and frame it perfectly square, turn off perspective. Press F so that it frames it to the documents. Because I messed up the edges of my rectangle, it's going to mess up the capture a little bit. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to gently zoom in just a little bit, just to cut out those ugly edges. Then we're going to go to alpha and grab doc. And then here we have our alpha. Let's go ahead and export this to Photoshop. Export. And go ahead and name it and open it in Photoshop. All right, we're in Photoshop now. You'll notice that this is not tileable at all because the two edges that are going to be tiling, so in the vertical, do not match up. So in Photoshop, we're going to use the clone brush to fix those edges up. First step is to go to Filter, Other, and Offset. And what this will do is it'll allow you to offset your texture. Offset it about halfway, and you'll be able to see, yeah, that does not match up and that would not make a good brush. However, when you hit OK, let's go ahead and duplicate the layer, we can go ahead and just clone brush this seam out. The clone brush is going to be found right here, and the way it works is you alt-click where you want to clone from, so I'm going to alt-click down here, and then I'm just going to go ahead and get the preview, try to make my stitches match up as much as possible, and then click accept, basically like that. I'm going to just erase here a little bit a mistake that I made and check the before and after. It's not perfect, it's not bad either. I think I'm going to just fix this one stitch here that's kind of faded, and then we can go from there. Okay, that's it in Photoshop. Let's go ahead and file, export, and export this as a PNG and open it in ZBrush. To open an alpha in ZBrush, we're going to go to the alpha option in the brush, import, and just select your file. Let's go ahead and create a sphere, make polymesh 3D, divide it up a few times so it looks nice, and let's go ahead and just put that in with the standard brush. Turn on that alpha. Let's do drag rectangle just to check. Okay, there are a few little issues. Part of it is that it's kind of looking pudgy. You see that? If I do dots, let's see. So part of the problem is that when I curve, it looks really weird and faceted. And if you notice here, all the stitches are kind of going through each other. So there's a few things we're going to need to fix. And do that. But all in all, not the worst first try, right? So the first thing we're going to do is, let me put one stroke down, for example, just for us to be able to compare. We're going to go to stroke, modifiers, and roll. What this will do is that it will make sure that the alpha gets applied entirely before it's applied again. That way, the stitches won't go through each other as much. Like that. You can kind of start to see that the stitches are looking a little bit more defined than before. Hopefully. Next thing we're going to do is going to stroke, lazy mouse. We're going to make sure that that's on, but the lazy step is going to be 0.001. And look at that. Ooh! Way too strong. Let's turn that down. This is also going to help not have any sort of overlapping. Look at the before and after. Can you already tell that it's looking a little bit better? So one problem we still have is that as we curve our brush, the alpha gets messed up, especially this way. You see that those lines coming in, it's just not very nice. The way we're going to fix that is by going to brush. We're going to go to auto masking, turn on directional, and then make it really nice and steep like this. Now let's see. It's not perfect, but it's a hell of a lot better. Look at this. Look at the stitches right here in the curve before versus after. The very last problem we have to fix is that the brush is looking a little pudgy, inflated. That's because this is an alpha that is both additive and subtractive, which is very problematic, but we can make it work. What we're going to do is we're going to open up the alpha menu, bring it to the side, and go to modify. Then we're going to turn the mid value up until we kind of find a happy medium that makes it kind of more flat. I think this might be it here. See how it's less pudgy? We can't see this big roundness anymore. So now, let's go ahead and tone down the intensity and test it out for real. Let's see it in action with this shirt that I made today in my workshop. Let's see. Maybe make the brush smaller, maybe a little bit more intense. And start kind of cutting in the seams. Oh, I should divide the shirt up. It's an important part of applying alphas, right? Test. Nice. If you need it to not be wobbly like this, go ahead and go to stroke, lazy mouse, and turn the lazy radius up so that you can control the straightness a little bit better. And turn down the intensity a bit. Not bad. I feel like my sculpting of it all needs to be refined a little bit, but I'm not unhappy with it.
And there you have it. This was probably one of the most straightforward and clear ways to make your own cloth seams and stitch brushes in ZBrush and Photoshop. If you enjoyed this tutorial, make sure to like this video, subscribe to this YouTube channel, and follow me on social media.
But wait, because that's not all.
Did you know you can watch me work live and get all of your questions answered? I stream on Twitch and here on this YouTube channel every Sunday at 5 p.m. Central Time. If you want to take your art career to the next level, I need somebody to help you via guidance, encouragement, keeping you accountable, and really pushing your skills, feel free to check my one-on-one mentorship. Every mentorship is different and completely personalized. We will work together to gain extreme clarity on your strengths, weaknesses, and goals. Then we will work together to create a game plan, and then I will support you through your journey with whatever is needed. Things like feedback and critiques, advice, book recommendations, tutorials, and things like that. And not to mention the meetings, of course. I also do a weekly online group class in which we focus on many of the fundamentals of sculpting, such as anatomy, form, and observation. The main goal is to increase your mastery over 3D sculpture, the software, and the medium in general through a series of challenging yet inspiring works. Feel free to drop any tutorial requests you might have down below, and I see you in the next one.